Our next speaker is Stanislav Nieszko from Oslo, and also University of Technology, and he will be speaking about the topic landscape.
Thank you very much, hello. I would like to report very quickly, present a very quick report. The idea is related to the previous talks. Previous talks and the results of Alexei and others concerning the implicit divergence equations, but the different aspects of which I consider this now. So if you have, for example, I know that in this conference everything is dynamics. Everything is dynamics, but it's a question if in dynamics there is any statics. There is also statics in dynamics. If you have, for example, fast dynamics and slow dynamics, then the slow dynamics seems sometimes like some constant objects, some constant sets and so on. So if you have cells in which the flows are presenting in some sense the interface, then which are also moving. Everything is in some sense in dynamics, but this is a slow dynamics. Then the system which is governing this is unique, should be unique. That means that not just separated into certain systems. So that should be unified. And then I would like to present you the approach to that. So of course, if you have, say, let's start with your Hamiltonian system, because there's energy, there's enough energy, and so on, and then this boundaries here, the sets, should be included in the system. What? I don't need anymore. So, for recalling the basic definitions, we have a symplectic manifold and then Hamiltonian fields, that you very well know this, and then we have a tangent bundle, GM. We have a natural symplectic structure defined by the structure on symplectic space M, and this is the structure which is saying something about important about the structure of the field itself globally. And then if this is Hamiltonian system, then of course this is Lagrangian submanifold in this tangent bundle, and if n is Lagrangian, then it's called Hamiltonian system. And of course, it might be implicit in the sense that its projection into basis, the M is singular projection. Then the singular projection and singular value set gives some structure on M and also on the configurational space. But that's another story. Then you have. So what we set for? We set for algebraic structure of that. For example, normal Poisson algebra, you know, this is just this algebra which is given the basic invariants of the system, of the mechanical system. And then, this is the symplectic coordinates. And then Poisson structures are very fundamental here. For symplectic spaces, this is obvious, this is canonical, and when the situation is degenerated, is singular, then we have different structures. We can expect to have, we have Poisson's complete structures, which are defining in some sense the properties of singularities. And that is the reason for this report. If we first, very simple approach, if we have a submanifold in symplectic space, the submanifold is defined by functions, I say smooth submanifold, by AI functions, you see, like the case of manifold. Then, of course, if you consider the symplectic structure, then it's degenerated. Sometimes that's generically, it depends on the dimensions and so on. And then the structure of, algebraic structure of the singularity is the question. Is the question how to find Poisson-Lie algebra appropriate for that situation. Of course, if this restriction is symplectic, I mean omega over residual case, then of course restriction of the usual Poisson algebra. But if not, then of course there is some construction here. So the first generalization of such Hamiltonian system is defined there. So the LB is called. This is. We restrict our formula for Hamiltonian system to the vectors tangent to the constraint k. Now, this is studied already by Dirac and others. But then this LB is kind of constraint Hamiltonian system is the same dimension as usual. But this is if B is zero, then for example. This is the conormal bundle to K. This is so that's not so difficult here to understand that. And there is natural generating function for this LB, for this Hamiltonian system. So generalized Hamiltonian system, which is down there F on, and this is defined by the functions defined in the constraint, and just B, which is the general kind of general Hamiltonian for that. But if we consider that function F. And we can ask, what is this? This is how a Hamiltonian vector fit over it. It is tangent to the constraint or not? Of course not. This LB is quite general, and each point is a fiber and so on. But of course, now we search for tangent from that vectors. We want to choose the tangent one. So a logarithmic vector fits, of course. So then, this is the construction, how does look like this vector field. And so we have to solve such equation. That equation star. That is, if we solve this equation according to lambda, and this is linear type of equations, depending on x, y, right hand side is the Poisson, usual Poisson bracket. Defined in symplectic space, omega in that space. And if we solve this, and then back to the function f over there, then we get a function which is defined in Hamiltonian, tangent to the tangent to k. To boundary. So logarithm, I don't use this notation because that's not maybe necessary here. And then there's a natural theorem, which was necessary to prove that equation star has a smooth solution defined on k, even only if b belongs to the first is ideal, just algebraic star. So this is Poisson normal function. So this is, you take, here is defined, yeah. It's defined, you take all h such that the Poisson bracket with ai should be written for each I, zero for all. So this is the Poisson orthogonal. This is, if b belongs to that, then it is tangent to the, it does depend on the symplectic form restricted to k. This is very important. That because if it is symplectic, then this is a regular situation, and no nothing astonishing us for that. So now some notation. Of course, we have here some objects. This function f, which this where we have these solutions of that linear equation lambda, it's not easy to solve linear equations like that. So it's a mother theorem for solution of that. But that's And then we defined h ak, because there's many parameters here, k, functions a, and so on. But then manifold, which is defined by this h here, is an image by this canonical math or in this vector space, given the proper equations. So if f belongs to h, to the space of this, then the Hamiltonian vector field is tangent to k. And then we have a theorem that this space of functions, which is the orthogonal Poisson orthogonal to k, which is normal symmetric form is standard. But here Poisson orthogonal to k is depends on k. Very depends on k. So this set is this algebra is very might be very complicated. So then this is a Poisson algebra with respect to omega. So that means that if we have two such functions, then they belongs to, then we take the Poisson bracket, then it depends, it belongs to H. But it's of course not all, but only those functions from that orthogonal Poisson algebra for then defined by A. So, equivalently, that is written there, and then this is also symplectic invariant, this algebra, of course. So that equivalency here is quite natural if you have two map germs defined by A parameters, A functions, A1 to AK, A1 to AK. But we have the symplectic structure there. We have to have equivalency, symplectic equivalency, which is not so easy sometimes. Equivalently, there is a symplectic diffeomorphism phi. You see that, and a family of regular matrices such that that we have this relation. And then this equivalency gives us also equivalence of these algebras. So this is quite a natural object for studying. Maybe example. This is example. If k is less than equal n, it depends on, of course, on the dimensions of the set to an extent. So rank of this matrix defined by this is a fundamental matrix. This one defined by Poisson brackets of function defining k. And this is the rank of that is constantly zero on R2M. Then this is symplectically equivalent to the projection map germ. So just should be maybe written some different way, not P, but it's that's just equivalent symplectically. So then algebra for that defined, which is equivalent to that in this variables. No, it's defined down there. So this is the touch. But this, you see, this is an idea defined by generated by coordinates y to until k, and then the part which is does depend on y. So then of course it's possible to calculate it in the simplest cases. The subgebras they are quite interesting. No, of course, if we have a Hamiltonian system on submanifolds and this k, comma omega k is symplectic, then of course you have just a standard situation. We have all Hamiltonians defined by this function with solutions that's very regular situation, and no, not in which might be saying something of singularity, but no singularities in this case. If we have generic submanifolds, for example, generic submanifolds, the one is you have symplectic equivalency, and then K0 is the simplest one. K1 is defined by this y^2 − 1 or y squared. This is the second one. And then this matrix, a fundamental matrix, which is defining finally the class algebra is like that. It's obvious because this is to some extent interesting. Then example for the Poisson algebra is the simplest case on two-dimensional space. The two parameters is y1 and yx2. We parameterize this two-dimensional symplectic space. So smooth function germs on Kalman defined by that by b belonging to y1 square ideal defined by that, and this is a Poisson algebra on that that case for the generally K1 case. So the another case is if we have this implicit system defined parametrically. Parametrically means that we have mapping, like here, R to n into R to n omega on the symplectic space on some open set U of R to n. That's of course this is local. Most of this here, which I show, is local results. Then we defined vector field defined by such formula, which is mechanical formula. I mean, this is standard formula, but this form is singular. We assume that F bar is not regular, because if it's regular, this is clear. If this is singular, then of course it has no smooth solutions here for x, h, usually have no problem. Then we search for smooth solutions. And it appears that if you find all smooth solutions, it is algebra. This is this was very interesting for searching this Lie Poisson algebra. And then that for this formula for each vector field example, and then we define the space H bar so that each functions H such that this vector field is smooth. In fact, this H is maybe not obvious here. Maybe only this is here, but it is a kind of generating function for isotropic leaf of L bar. So Poisson bracket here now, we have just usual Poisson bracket, like it was, I mean, by defined by symplectic form, singular symplectic form, because on the smooth vector field, it's working well. This good Poisson bracket on this algebra, on this set of smooth solutions. So this is kind of mechanics of that situation. And if we assume that regular point set is dense in U, then we have easy proof. I mean, this is assumption that this H F bar is closed under the bracket which we defined. This is the bracket which we define there, which is symplectic, generated symplectic form. And this space is a Poisson algebra, fulfills all conditions of Poisson algebra. So, and then we call it like that. And, behind of that? Behind of that is a situation that if you have, for example, this implicit differential system was then you have this critical point here. And if you like to smoothly solve this equation, then of course it's a problem. Before, linear programs are not smooth solutions, especially in that point. But if you want to, let's take one dimensional case. So x dot here, x here, and you have your set is this one. Then how to solve it? It's impossible to solve because this is at that point, because at that point, velocity is positive, is this one, but you have to stop there. So no smooth solution. The smooth solution is only in one case when you have, if this is like that. If this is like that, then of course you move like you come here, you stop and come back. So that means that you come here, then you have this the image of this. If you can, if you lift the solution to the tension bundle, then you are on this set. Here you cannot be on this set. So this is the question. In physical problems, people are searching for such systems where they are solid. If they are not solvable, then it's difficult to play with them sometimes. Or not always, but sometimes. So this is that property. And that appears that all these Poisson-Lee algebras are defined by solvable systems, implicit systems, by solvable. And this is the kind of very nice unified view on that problem. Of course, very basic. That's not. So that means solvable systems. Solvable means that you have because this is implicit system that at each point you find a neighborhood such that. It's a solution of the system that you can lift it to the manifold. Well, yeah. So this is the equivalence. Then, Poisson-Lee algebra for Courant non-singularities, because this is simplest. It's possible to calculate the Courant one, and we don't define the singularity here. There might be some singularity with calculations possible. But then, so for this, and especially for that one, simplest one, we have Poisson-Lee algebra defined by. So these Poisson brackets are like that, you see? And of course, this is divisible here. So that is well defined, and then the space of functions which is the space of invariants of this mechanics of this world, of this mechanical world, is defined by that. All functions of which partial derivatives according to U and Vn belongs to the idea defined by Jacobi matrix determinant of Jacobi idea of Jacobi matrix. By Jacobi matrix of F bar. And this is an example, but of course, if to calculate more complicated situations or more, that was possible because we have normal form here. We have normal form, which is, you see, in Vn squared here. So then it was possible. If not normal form, then it's more difficult to calculate such things. For normal form, it's possible to calculate, but on the symplectic normal forms. Because if no symplectic, then we have no consistence, of course. So this is like that. Well, there are some applications, but maybe I leave it now because that's all what I want to say. It's important.